So I'm going to show you how to transit from a TM mode to the STEM mode. So first, after you bring sample to focus, find your location of interest in the TM mode, and we just release the condenser aperture. Just turn the aperture counterclockwise, so the red button is aligned with the black corner there. Okay, then the next steps are mostly just a software application. So we just go to the dialog box. Okay, I try to bring to focus better for you. Okay. So we go to dialog and select ASID control and just click ASID. And then you will change mode to the STEM mode. And after that, you click alignment. What do we see on the screen? You should see these shapes. So normally we don't need adjustment. If it's a shape is off the center, normally we need to click. I'm sorry, when you start the software, let's come. Yeah. Let's start the software called GOL Simple View. Okay. So, in the GeoSimple view, if the beam when started is not on the screen, you need click scan and spot button, scan and spot button. Make sure the spot is centered. Okay, so it's centered. So you should get this one. If it's still after you click scan spot, it's still not in the center, you use a bright tilt button on. Just click this button. You can adjust the shift and tilt or the deflection. I'm sorry, it's called deflection on this knob. These four knobs, the four knobs close to the viewing window to make it to this shape. Okay. So when you adjust the shape, you're basically moving around. And then when you adjust the deflection, it's actually just your tilt, okay? So you change the outer shadow. I don't know how to call it. The outer side of not very bright region around the circle, okay? To make it uniform. So. All right, so this is when you click alignment, the next thing after you click alignment, then you go to map. Okay, here, click map. So you change the magnification. So we use the biggest knob, magnification knob. We change the magnification. The magnification reading is here to the maximum. It's 150 m. Okay, you will hear a beep. And after that, you need to change, you see the camera lens here is HDF5. When you change the camera lens, which is here, okay, change the camera lens to 40. So you click that until 20 is okay. Okay, so after the camera lens there, we click scan spot again. What you will see, something on the screen. At the moment, it's just too bright to see anything. Okay, so what you need to do, you need to adjust the Z gently. So make sure the cause button here is up, okay? And then you adjust the Z button up and down. If you also pay attention to the Z, the speed here. Maybe make it to the medium speed. So now it's medium. The three arrow there, a three triangle there, which means fast. And the two, which means medium. And the one is slow. So we go to the medium. Now we adjust the Z, the button. Okay, two finger here up, one is up, one is down. So we adjust the Z until we see something called rangigram. So you see something now. I don't know how good we can go. Okay, so this is on the screen. Okay, you will see just around near the black spot there, you see something called rangigram. Normally, I don't need user to do anything to do the adjustment. For me, I have to do some alignment here to make it good. So you make the rangigram about 5 millimeter in size. Okay, you can also use a small screen, which can help you position it. So maybe you can see a little bit better. Now the rangigram is around the right upper corner, if you pay attention to it, of the small screen center is up, okay? So now you can adjust the rangigram to the screen center. So to do that, you have to use the projection lens, click the PRA button, which is here, the PRA button. So this is dark. Okay, the PAA button, just click on. Okay, then we adjust the position of the rangigram. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more. So we will focus here. You can see it. Okay, we adjust the position of the user deflection, the lower two knobs near the viewing screen to bring it to the screen center. We bring it to screen center, just easy for you to find it, okay? So we know which is, this is in the screen center. This is rangigram. All right. Okay, after that, we need to put the condenser aperture, which is above, we played earlier. We need to put the condenser aperture right on the rangigram. Okay, so you can see one. I add, normally we use a third aperture, two. See, when the second aperture added, you can see it. Okay, we add another one, three. The third aperture, so you use a position knob of the condenser aperture to move the circle to the screen center. Because we move the logic here, we have to put the aperture right on the rangigram, at the center of the rangigram. So when we move the rangigram to the screen center, we just simply add, it's just easier for most people, we just simply add the condenser aperture to the screen center. So that is centered, okay? After that, we need to change the camera lens, okay? So you change the camera lens, which is here. Okay, on the software, we change the camera lens. You can see the camera lens reading here. We change the camera lens to the camera lens you need for your STEM imaging. So that depends on your material, depends on what you want to see. For this session, we can go to HADF5. Okay, this is HADF5. So after you adjust the camera lens, you come to the screen, you will notice, oh, that tiny spot is not on the screen center. So for this instrument, it's very difficult for us to take a video here. So the logic, you see, we need to make sure this part, which is a direct beam, go to the detector center, the STEM detector center, okay? Today, we are going to use a geo detector, the dark field detector, which is the left row, upper here. Okay, we just need load it in. Okay. So this is how we from TMO transition to demo. The next thing, you just need to start a scan. After you load the detector, start scanning, you will get your image. Oh, don't forget to change magnification to now it's 150 amp, you will see nothing. So you need to change magnification to low. You can locate a large area. So normally we start from 100K. For example, 50K is okay.